Good morning. Today we're gonna do a little shop with me, Dollar Tree. You're staring at my slippers because we gotta change out of these. And we're also probably gonna make a beach stop. Alright, I got here to Dollar Tree a little bit early, and I wanted to take this time to tell you guys that my new Etsy kits have dropped, and I already posted on my Instagram, and I'm slightly shook at the fact that I've had so many orders already without, like, even coming on YouTube to let you guys know. So thank you for those of you that have already placed your order. I actually have some that are getting shipped off today already. Yeah, so it's my junk journal mystery kit. If you go to the Etsy listing, which is linked down below, the listing will tell you everything you need to know. There is a 1 to 2 week turnaround time on the kits, but I am trying to obviously get them out as soon as possible. I just put this buffer just in case. It's hard for me to gauge how many orders I'm gonna get, and because each order is unique, and yeah, it just takes time, so that's just like a buffer, but I will try to get them out as quickly as possible. But they are by far my favorite kits I've ever done, like, to the point where I'm considering letting this kit run for a lot longer than I think I originally planned. But anyway, so if you want to get your hands on it, it's linked down below, and it is super cute. It's colorful, it's beautiful, it's vintage, it's spring, Valentine's Day. It is such a fun kit. And yeah, so but in case you guys can't or don't want to spend that money on the kit, while we go into Dollar Tree, I'll point out a couple of things that you can get yourself for junk journaling.
Why is that, like, so adorable? Oh, a sloth. Oh my gosh, that is so cute. Wait, what is this? Oh, another sloth. Not the dinosaur, okay, yeah. They even have the little gnome, which is super cute. I'm gonna get these three. Even a little unicorn. They're starting to put out all of their boxes and all of these cute little, like, mailboxes, which are so cute. Like, look at this one. That one's precious. This would be great for junk journals because you can make shaker cards. These are just cute in general for the kids. Care packages. Ooh, look how cute those are. Love that sign that was out last year. Oh my gosh, these were out too, I think. These little metal envelopes. I love those hearts right there. Those hearts are absolutely amazing. They also have that color. There's another hot pink color. If you do a Valentine's Day, like, Christmas tree of sorts, these actually would be really great fillers in them. And they're linked, so you can actually take them apart and then just spread them around individually. Here's that new label that I showed you guys in the last haul. Oh my gosh, look. What? I already got all of the garland. They have birdhouses. And it's all, like, this wood color, so you can just paint it whatever you want. A Okay, so ribbon at Dollar Tree is amazing for junk journaling, and look at this, the little beads. What? I love the gingham and this one too, but the hearts are slightly off-centered. Oh my gosh, look how cute this typewriter sticker is. Oh yeah, we're just gonna load up on those. You can make these little DIY macrame cactus. Is that? Oh, look, little. That's cute. These would be cute for Valentine's Day baskets, care packages. Ooh, I love. Y'all know I love jumbo cards. Look at these outfits. Oh, look at her. It's giving Pan Am in the 50s. It's just missing a hat. These little green hearts are so cute for junk journaling. And honestly, just any of the little stones, because they have like a flat back. So they just make it really easy to like glue down. Every time I come, I always have to look at the books, the coloring books, the puzzles, see if there's kind of anything new. That's so cute. I'm sorry. What the hell is this? Is that not a hockey book? I'm taking that with me. That's for damn sure. Where are there any more? I need to find a score. Where is it? What is going on here? That look she's giving him? I mean, something's going down.
Oh, wow. So we're back home now. I actually meant to do the haul like in the car in the parking lot at the beach, but I ended up coming home. And okay, here's Loki. He's actually facing the camera. Look how handsome you are today. I just put makeup on, that's why I back away, because then it's just, you know. You're, oh, I can't. He is like, he's a teddy bear. He is a teddy bear, except with like really wild, uncontrolled paws. So it's kind of like a scary teddy bear, but like not on purpose. Yeah. Yeah. Do you like my braid? He's like, that's how you always do your hair. Well, I'm not a hairstylist, so what do you want from me? All right, such a good haul. I'm just, I literally have been hauling how many years now, and it always feels new to me. Okay, so also there's quite a bit of snacks in here as well. Where do I think we've got 3 bags to sift through today. So I found these Twizzlers. What are they called? Nibs? Nibs? Does that sound wrong? They're individually wrapped though, and it is the cherry flavor. I thought these were really cute. These were actually in the regular candy aisle at my store. They were not in the Valentine's Day candy section. So just kind of like keep that in mind if you're going to go shop for candy for gift baskets and things like that for Valentine's Day. I had to do it. It's one of my favorite items at Dollar Tree. So whenever I see like my favorite things, every so often, I'll just grab it again. And then I had to get quite a few of the heart lace. This is another great item that you can pick up yourself to junk journal with. It's so cute. There's not that much. I mean, I'll say that. So maybe if you're going to use lace in a massive quantity or like a bigger quantity, you might be better off going like Michael's or craft store or Hobby Lobby for those. But just so you know, cute little lace is at Dollar Tree. So I got quite a few of those. And then I saw this absolutely adorable little teddy bear keychain. I don't really know what I'm gonna do with this keychain yet, but I think I'm gonna use it for my junk journal. I looked for another teddy bear because I wanted 2 of them, because I actually thought about putting it like on my actual keychain with my keys. I don't have like a fun little keychain. Plus he has little stars. How cute is that? But yeah, so I'm gonna have to be on the hunt for another one, but this one I'm gonna put aside for my junk journal, just to like kind of like create a tassel effect. Then I picked up turtles. Whenever I go shopping at Dollar Tree, I get myself a little treat. Do it. I don't know why, but it's fun. It makes it, you know? Then I found the pearl trim. All right, I was just in the mood for Fruit Loops, but I do try to stay away from cereal because the ingredients aren't great, but sometimes I just need the snack, you know what I mean? So I got this little bag of Fruit Loops. They also have them in like those little like cup things, so I got that. Then I picked up the yogurt covered raisins, a Dollar Tree taste test. Pretty good size. Immediately, yogurt. I've had yogurt covered things, so I can kind of compare. Ten out of 10. It tastes good. It tastes fresh. It's so good, it almost kind of tastes like white milk chocolate. Absolutely. Then I saw these cinnamon apple chips. Let's try those too. That like a full-on slice of apple. It says USA apples. I mean, not like absolutely bursting with flavor, but there is flavor. Oh yeah. And I really, when it comes to like dried fruit, I bought a bunch from Dollar General and I tried all of them and I liked the strawberries the most, but like I want to like all of them so much and sometimes I just can't. 9.5 out of 10. Honestly, maybe even just a 10. 10 out of 10. This is good. It was exactly like what I was hoping for it to be, so definitely met the expectations. All right, so that was bag one. Now let's do bag number two.
Nibs. What the hell are nibs?
All right, so in this bag, I have to just talk about these hearts right here because they are so simple. They've been around at Dollar Tree for, I don't even know at this point. I mean, as long as I can remember, they have this little piece here, which you could easily pluck off if you don't want it to be like a wreath style, but these are going to be great for wreaths. So like if you have a little side business selling wreaths or an Etsy shop and you do wreaths, one, you probably already know about this item, but also if you're doing a Christmas tree, like I mentioned before, like a Valentine's Day tree, this is going to make your tree look so freaking gorgeous. I'm gonna insert a picture here that I actually found on Pinterest, just so that you can see, and you can tell in the photo, they used these in the tree, and they're just so underrated. They are probably the number one best item, in my opinion, at Dollar Tree for Valentine's Day. I mean, even the shape of them kind of have somewhat of a Dr. Seussy whimsical look to it. I probably saw where I was picking up some stickers and I got this one. You can definitely pause on the screen if you want to take more time looking at it. The first thing that caught my attention immediately was the slice of pie right here with the hearts. Loki's trying to eat the peeps that are in the bag. But yeah, super cute. So I got two sheets of those and then I had to get three of these because this is brand new. The little typewriter, the stamp, the envelopes. It has like a whole, you know, mail thing to it. And I think it's so adorable. There's even the camera. So love it. Okay, then you saw that I did decide to take home the little gnome, which again, I'm not a gnome person. I'm gonna stop saying that, but I don't know why. I just decided he had to come home to my car. I thought he was so pretty. And tear tray. Like, you can't tell me this isn't like just built perfectly for that. And I love how nicely finished it is. Like $1.25, what? This one's probably going to be a huge sellout. Despite, even with like this part that's kind of got a cheapy look to it, but even then somehow all of this comes together and it is so cute. I don't remember this little bottle of rosé from last year. Love that they have the black. I mean, all of these little sweet details for $1.25. Cute. This is going to be adorable for a gift basket. So go scoop that up. And then the third one that I got was the little dinosaur. I have a thing for dinosaurs during Valentine's Day. Like, what does that even mean? Look at him holding this little red heart. He's kind of not as finished and well done. So definitely look at all of your options in the box, you know, just try to get like the best one possible, but he looks great from this side. Maybe that's just your best side, huh? Yeah, we all got it, I know. All right, another thing of lace hearts. And then I did pick up the little metal, yeah, it's like a little metal envelope. It is super cute, you have this. So these would also be really cute as ornaments if you do a Valentine's Day tree. And then the best one, in my opinion, is the galvanized one. So yeah, I really like that. It has a super cute farmhouse thing to it. Even if you just wanna get this and maybe, let's say you have a command center at home and you have maybe like a slot for your kids, like each kid has their own hook or cubby or whatever, these would be really cute. You could even like put their name on the back or somewhere on the front or just like an initial. Maybe over the heart, and then you can leave them little letters. Card, I love looking at the cards because I love junk journaling with them. And I got this one because it was just really plain and simple, didn't have any other message going on, so it'll be super easy to craft with. All right, then I found a chocolate bomb, but it is the Valentine's Day. So they did this for Christmas. Super cute, love that. That would be great for a gift basket too, or just for like your bar cart or your coffee bar, hot chocolate bar station. Loki has his face literally in my lap. Okay, then I did pick up some peeps. Now, they already started putting out a bunch of their peeps, and I'm so excited also for Easter. So I have never seen the sour watermelon. I feel like this is new at Dollar Tree. Then I found the sparkly wild berry, and they are in fact sparkly. Then I found these little individual packs, milk chocolate covered marshmallow. But yeah, it's a marshmallow on the inside. Up the little craft shapes. So cute. We're getting little flowers. We're getting little mugs. We're getting little watering cans in there and pots. Like, oh no, that's not a mug. That's a watering can. I see it now. But that's super adorable. This junk journal, 100%. They're so thin and flat that these would be really cute, and then you can paint them whatever color. So I love that. I picked up the little green hearts, and I'm going to show you the little green hearts again in a second. And then I picked up the confetti because I'm going to be making shaker cards. And then I also found these table scatter. Now, what really caught my attention were the lips. That, tell me that's not adorable. The little heart. And then they've got multiple diamond shapes. They've got the little baby one and then the bigger one, which is so cute. Girl, wait a minute. Just let me have a moment. I do. Are you gonna be home all the time though, or? Okay, because that could change the answer. And something that I think will really elevate your hot cocoa bar, your coffee station, are these pretzels. They are so cute. They're pretzel sticks. They are in the Valentine's Day section of the candy, so definitely look there first. I don't know why I thought that was the last bag, but it's not. I also picked up the little rhinestone thing, so I got the package of the hearts. These are so cute. Like I said in the video, I love that they have a flat back, so they're great to craft with. And then I got the little picket fence of flowers, or a box of flowers. I don't really know. So I thought those were really cute. And then I wanted to show you guys, they also have these metal galvanized hearts at Dollar Tree. These are really cute because, one, they have the heart effect, plus you can actually create a whole vintage thing inside of this. I'll try to throw up a picture here as well. Something that I saw on Pinterest the other day, and I just thought it was so adorable. But if you're definitely into like vintage things like I am, these little hearts would be a great pickup for a project like that. The picture I think will be kind of self-explanatory, but because it has like a shadow boxy type of effect without a cover, these are going to be great for a project like that. So I also picked up some candles, and these are new, so I'm super excited to review them. I have not smelled them. I'm gonna do it on camera now and tell you guys what I think. But if you're new to my channel, I love the Dollar Tree little candles. I use them in smaller bathrooms in my house, and they're amazing. This one is Bartlett Pear Cider. And like, how beautiful is this packaging? Also, I want to point out that the wax actually comes up almost to the top on these little jars. Sometimes Dollar Tree, like, they're half. And it's like, really? Yeah, it smells like a candied pear. And I really like that. So, love it. Okay, this next one is French toast and pumpkin butter. That's funny because the first thing that I thought of when I smelled this was fall. So I don't know if like, this one says harvest. And these just showed up at my Dollar Tree. If you do not go to Dollar Tree right now and smell this candle, oh, it smells like a breakfast restaurant. This one is harvest berry. Like, look at this color. It looks like jam. That's what it looks like. I really like that. Oh my God, I don't know which one I like the most. The French toast is number one. Harvest two, pear third. And that's saying a lot because I really love this pear. We're gonna end today's haul. Probably gonna talk 10 minutes about this book because I've been talking about hockey, and I did a review of hockey books over on my vlog channel. I did, I think, an hour-long book review. And when I first picked this book up, and I think you can kind of tell in the video where I found it, at first I just saw this, and that was, ladies, good night. That was all I needed to personally see. And then I saw the hockey stick, and I said, a San Francisco Thunder novel, Victoria Denault. I'm gonna have to probably buy Score if this turns out to be good. I'm gonna be busy later, okay? All right, so that's it for the haul, but I'm gonna share with you guys some items that I need to just take a couple photos, but then they're gonna be available on Etsy. I think they'll be available by the time you guys are seeing this. So I'm gonna swing it to where I'll post these journals as soon as this video goes up. But I'm gonna also be selling super adorable little junk journals that I made, and look how cute. So here are the little green hearts. This is what I wanted to show you guys. So this is just the cover of the book. It's like a little mini composition notebook. Like, look how darling that trim is. But yeah, I only have these four right now. I am going to be making more. So if there's any that you want from here, they are going to be listed for sale on my Etsy shop, link down below. Plus, like I mentioned earlier, my junk journal kits are also available right now. So how cute is this one? And then tell me that's not so darling. Yeah, so anyways, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, the shopping. I think there might have been some beach clips, I'm not entirely sure. Before you leave, if you're not subscribed, please do so. If you just want to like hang out with me, I'll show you guys all of the Dollar Tree finds that I think are the best for $1.25. And that's it. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.